From simple toys to work tools for surveillance or transport, drones have taken on an important function. But they pose a threat to air traffic if they veer into airspace reserved for scheduled flights. What's being done to avoid dangerous close encounters? Kuhn is the owner of a Belgian company that manufactures drones designed for the movie and television industry. He's testing his latest product in a public park in Antwerp. Detailed knowledge of the airspace is needed, given its proximity to the city's airport.
The moment you take a course, you get a lot of information on the airspace. We get plans where we can see visually where the locations are, where a controlled zone from an airport is, where a helicopter training area is, and how we have to look at it on the plan.
The importance of that information is growing. The billion-euro drone market is expected to create tens of thousands of jobs. This Belgian company develops software so drone pilots can navigate the varied and complex rules for drones. Its free smartphone app looks at where you want to fly and tells you whether the area is unrestricted, if special authorization is required, or if drones are forbidden.
We know we are standing near an airport. And if you look at the system, indeed, it tells me on the spot, you cannot fly here because I don't know yet why. I just click a bit further and it will tell me in detail why I am not allowed to fly here.
With the latest apps, a virtual dome is mapped over the area where the drone is operated. It prevents it swerving into unauthorized airspace by creating a virtual wall.
So there's a link between our software and the drone that informs him, watch out, the virtual wall is here, you cannot continue.
Air traffic regulators need to work fast to meet the demand from drones.
The biggest challenge we are facing is, on the one hand, we have a very conservative aviation community where we take quite a long years to make changes because we want to keep everything very safe. And now we have a very innovative industry coming up who doesn't want to wait 5 to 7 years and who wants to implement things now.
Regulations, which vary from country to country, need to be harmonized across Europe to keep scheduled passenger flights and drones operating safely without unnecessary complications.